Let's start. We have Red here. Of course, what are the things that he has done? Examples of his lawlessness, that how he's stolen the clothes, how he injured the owner of the costume shop, right? And yes, so when he went into the departmental store also, he ate over there, he slept there. And in the morning when the assistants came, how they likely had to run away, right? So now he's stolen money also from the shop of the old man. And where has he come to? So once you break the law, you keep on running away from it, right? So such a brilliant scientist has now become a law breaker. He should have been respected by society. He should have been given honor and recognition. But because of his deeds, because of what he did, he is not going to get that respectable place. And he's going to try to hide all the crimes that he has committed. Now let's continue the chapter. So I have latecomers joining me. So eager to get away from crowded London, he took a train to the village of Epping, where he booked two rooms at the local inn. So he went from London, he went to a small town or a village, that is the village of Epping, okay? What's an inn? Local inn. Nowadays we say hotels, right? So inns are, of course, hotels, but with small, lesser rooms, okay? Yeah. The arrival of a stranger at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. Why was it an unusual event in winter? Winter, there are not many guests. So you're having a guest coming in the middle of the winter, that person is booking two rooms. It is going to be something very nice. Nice for the owner? Yes or no? Yes. The arrival of the stranger at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. A stranger of such uncommon appearance set all tongues wagging. What was strange about the appearance? What was strange about his appearance? What are the things that he took from the costume store? Nose, false nose, put a hat, he wrapped bandages, right? Glasses, so that his face would have a shape. So everybody is wondering, why is he wearing bandages and all? What is wrong with him? Maybe he's mad with an accident, right? So his appearance is very strange. A stranger of such uncommon appearance, it all tongues wagging. What is tongues wagging mean? People talking, right? Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly. Now, because we are focusing on multiple choices, that means each and every little detail you need to be aware of. Earlier, it was so convenient. Ma'am would ask any value-based question and even write the summary of the chapter. Ma'am answered, "Dhoond lena apne." Now, no, it's not going to be like that. You have to be very, very clear about everything. It's now more hard work required from your point side, isn't it? Am I right, Chira? Yes? Okay. Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly, but Griffin had no desire to talk and told her, "My reason for coming to Epping is a desire for solitude. I do not wish to be disturbed in my work. Besides, an accident has affected my..." So he wanted to be alone. And he says, "Don't disturb me. I have to continue with my work." What is he working on now? He's discovered the formula of invisibility. What else do you think he's going to work on now? So he's to carry on with his scientific studies. Now he is going to make a formula to make him visible again. So he needs silence. He does not need any kind of disturbance. What explanation does he give to the bandages on his face? What does he say? "I met with an accident." Okay, right. Satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist. Eccentric. Who is an eccentric person? Who do we call an eccentric? Yeah. Mad scientist. Absolutely. When you think of scientists, you know, what do we think of them? Always busy with the test tubes and writing down their calculations and with the formula and all that stuff, isn't it? So we think of them as someone very focused on their work. Because they're so focused, we think that they are not normal, right? So eccentric, someone crazy, right? Yeah, so that way, absolutely correct. An eccentric scientist. And in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance. So she thought that he's given me money, I don't have to bother. So Mrs. Hall is also not verifying much about him. Who is he? Where is he come from? Why is the parents like this? Because he has given her money in advance, that too. Right? Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. He was very, you know, like rude also. But Mrs. Hall didn't have any problem with that. But the stolen money did not last long, and presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more ready cash. Where did he get the money from? It was stolen. Did he have any other source of income? No, he's run out of money. So he needs money, right? Yes, he pretended that he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. So what did he tell the landlady when he was not able to make the payment? I'm waiting for a check. My money is going to come. Then I will give you the payment. Okay, right? Shortly afterwards, a curious episode occurred. Very early in the morning, a clergyman and his wife were awakened by noises in the study. Creeping downstairs, they heard the chink of money being taken from the clergyman's desk. Now, who is a clergyman? Clergyman is there, like, you know, like you have the priest. Yes? So he is there responsible or taking care of the people of that area. Right? So the clergyman is there. He's an important person. And what happened here? Because he is there dealing with the people, he's also, you know, responsible for the welfare of the people, and he's dealing with money and things. So yes, so there was bound to be money at his home. So one night, what did he and his wife hear? They heard noises. And they also heard the clutter of coins. When you pick up coins and they fall down, they'll make a noise. And even when you pick them, right, so the sound there, and someone opening a drawer, taking out that money, the sound is going to be audible. And in the night when everything is quiet, it is going to be more clear, right? Yes. Without making any noise and with a poker, a stick, right? Delhi, we have the poker for the fireplace, right? For, you know, like, yes, look, taking care of that fire, tending the fire. So he had the poker. Grasp firmly in his hand, the clergyman flung open the door. The clergyman came, he heard the noises, he opened the door, he had a stick in his hand. If there is any thief, what am I going to do? Hit him. Surrender. Then, to his amazement, he realized that the room appeared to be empty. There's no one in the room. Why is the room empty? He could hear a sound. But why couldn't he hear anyone, see anyone? Because he was invisible. Very right. Yes. Then to his amazement, he realized that the room appeared to be empty. He and his wife looked under the desk, behind the curtains, and even up the chimney. Even that person has disappeared from there, escaped from there. There wasn't a sign of anybody. Yet the desk had been opened and the housekeeping money was missing. They couldn't see anybody, but a theft had taken place. Right? Who do you think was a thief? The invisible man. Griffin only was a thief. Extraordinary affair, the clergyman kept saying for the rest of the day. He's unable to understand what happened. Where did the money go? Nobody was seen, but the money was not there. So he could not understand what has happened. He's so surprised. But it was not as extraordinary as the behavior of Mrs. Hall's furniture a little later that morning. So there was something even more stranger that was going to happen. Mrs. Hall's furniture behaving strangely. The landlord and his wife were up very early and was surprised to see the scientist's door wide open. So if you read the book, you will find out, you know, the affair, there was going to be a fair and all the villagers were getting ready for it. Everybody was making something or the other. And the innkeeper had decided to get the drinks and all ready. So they had woken up early to make the preparations. And then when they woke up early, they saw the scientist's door open. Otherwise, do you think the scientist left his door open? No, because he was always busy in his work. He did not like to be disturbed. And he didn't want people to see him without his bandages and without the clothes, right? Usually it was shut and locked, and he was furious if anyone entered his room. The opportunity seemed too good to be missed, and they wanted to go inside his room and see what was there. They peeped around the door, saw nobody, and decided to investigate. The bedclothes were cold, showing that the scientist must have been up for some time. See, what presence of mind. The lady, she touched the bedclothes, right? And if you have been sleeping there and you've just got up a few minutes ago, the sheets are still going to be warm, but they were cold. That means that someone has been up for a long time. So no one was asleep on this bed. So the bed sheets were cold, showing that the scientist must have been up for some time. And stranger still, the clothes and the bandages that he always wore were lying about the room. So his clothes were there, his bandages were there, but he was not there. So there was some suspicion in the mind of the woman. All of a sudden, Mrs. Hall heard a sniff close to her ear. Sniffing. When do we sniff? When you have a cold? Yeah, you keep on sniffling? Due to dust particles, also some allergy you have, right? Okay. So sniffing also. Sometimes, yeah, you get, you know, like, of course, a very nice fragrance. Hey, mommy's cooking something very special, that aroma coming. And oh my God, right? You go running to the kitchen, wondering what is being cooked, isn't it? Right? So sniff. So that lady could hear someone sniffing. And imagine you can't see anybody, but you can hear. It's going to be quite scary. Yes, it is. A moment later, the hat on the bedpost leapt up and dashed itself into her face. So just like, you know, as in a sci-fi film or in a horror film, you know, the hat coming and hitting her face all of a sudden. Very strange, very scary, of course. Then the bedroom chair became alive. Springing into the air, it charged straight at her legs foremost. The chair also came alive. And it seems as if the chair is coming towards that lady. And how? The legs in front, right? So someone there kind of charging with the chair. But only the chair can be seen moving. Nobody can be seen holding the chair, right? As she and her husband turned away in terror, the extraordinary chair pushed them both out of the room and then appeared to slam and lock the door after them. It seems that the chair pushed both of them out. The chair was chasing them. First the lady, then the man, and sent them both out of the room. As soon as they were out, what happened to the door? Yeah, it was shut, right? So very, very strange. And for a person who is not aware why all these things are happening, what is that person going to think has happened to the furniture? There's some supernatural power. There's some ghost. Some spirits, right? So people are going to think that only. Mrs. Hall almost fell down the stairs in hysterics, in fear, in shock. What has happened? Chair pushed me out of the room. So she's very shocked. She was convinced that the room was haunted by spirits. Haunted by spirits? Bhoot hai room mein. There are spirits over there. And that the stranger had somehow caused these to enter into furniture. And the stranger had done some magic. And the spirits have entered into a furniture. That is why it is behaving like that. My poor mother used to sit in that chair. To think it should rise up against me now, it was a mother's chair. And she has been using it since a long time. And now she thinks, look at my chair is going against me. My chair is trying to hurt me. Very scary experience. Yes. The feeling among the neighbors was that the trouble was caused by witchcraft. What is witchcraft? What is witchcraft? Witchcraft. Is it witch ka kaam ho sakta hai? Witch kya kaam karti hai? Jadoo, spells, right? And what is it that makes us believe? Kyunki witches hain, aise spells hote hain. What makes us believe all that? What? The furniture moving here and there. That makes us believe. What else makes us believe? Different sensation comes in, so it makes us believe there's a spell. Is it? What do witches look like? Haan, phir? Hum kaise, how can we say? I've never seen one. But see here, people there believing in witchcraft. That means they had their superstitions, they had their beliefs. And of course, witches, they were said to be women with these extraordinary magical powers, right? Have you read about witches and wizards anywhere? Where? Where? Harry Potter, of course, we. Okay, right. So we have read about you can see the witches and wizards, and we're really amazed by all the things that were happening, weren't we? Yes, any Harry Potter fans here? Right, good, that's nice. No, yeah, I've also seen all the parts, right? Right? So like when the witches here, like casting all the spells, the wizards also there. And you see the witches, you know, with all those potions, they mix up and casting all that spells and doing all those things. So the villagers, they were very simple people. And they thought that someone has done some kind of magic. Right? So they believed in all that, right? Yes. And if you have seen that, you see that how the witches, they dress up with their cloaks and that hat and all, isn't it? Right? So Jenny, that is what we think about. Okay. But witchcraft or not, when the news of the burglary at the clergyman's home became known, the strange scientist was strongly suspected of having a hand in it. Now, two things have happened. One, what has happened at the clergyman's house? Money stolen. Second incident was the strange incident that happened that day. The furniture moving. So two things happening on the same day, right? And of course, when the furniture was moving, was the scientist anywhere around?
No.
People could not see him, although he was there, but people did not know. And because he was not there, because he was strange looking, because the villagers liked to talk about him, they thought that somehow he is and they were absolutely correct. Weren't they? Yes, they were. Right? Suspicion grew even stronger when he suddenly produced some cash, though he had admitted not long before that he had no money. When Mrs. Hall would ask him for money, what excuse did he give? Yes, that his check is on the way, is expecting money. All of a sudden, he had money. And the same day, money had been stolen. So if you put two and two together, you come to the conclusion, who's stolen the money? Yes, the scientist has stolen the money. Okay, right. The village constable was secretly sent for. Instead of waiting for the constable, Mrs. Hall went to the scientist who had somehow mysteriously appeared from his empty bedroom. When Mrs. Hall went into his room, he was not there. So when the constable was called for, when Mrs. Hall went over there, who was there in the bedroom? The scientist. Right? So very strange, very suspicious. What is happening? What is going on? Everyone is very surprised. I wanted to know what you have been doing to my chair upstairs. So she's not worried about anything else. She's saying, what have you done to my chair? Why is my chair jumping around here and there? That is what she is worried about. She demanded, and I want to know how it is you came out of an empty room and how you entered a locked room. Because when they were pushed out, the door was shut, right? It was locked. How did you come out of that room when you were not inside? So smart lady, right? Very observant also. And now she wants answers to this. Now look at this picture here. What is happening here in this picture? What is happening? Yeah, he's taking off his bandage. Right? Why do you think that is happening? He wants to scare the people? Or he wants to tell them the truth? No, it was not so quick. No, it is not. Now, the scientist was always quick-tempered. Quick-tempered. He used to get angry so easily. But now he became furious. He's angry. How can you talk to me like this? Why are you blaming me about all this? Right? You don't understand who or what I am, he shouted. Very well, I'll show you. You don't know me? Now I'll show you who I am. And even if he does show who he is, can people see him? So what's the use? So he wanted to show, see, I'm invisible. Right? Fine. So try to see me if you can. Suddenly, he threw off bandages, whiskers, spectacles, and even nose. What would be the reaction if someone just throws their nose now? Scary? Will faint only? Will scream? Isn't it? So imagine that man there showing, I'm showing you who I am, and he's taking off his nose. It took only a minute to do this. The horrified people in the bar found themselves staring at a headless man. Because as he took off his bandages, as he removed his nose, his glasses, his hat, everything, right? His head became invisible. But of course, yeah, he was wearing a suit and he was wearing his clothes. And imagine looking at a headless man. I think so people are going to have sleepless nights for a long time. Yeah, it's going to be very scary. Of course it is. Mr. Jaffers, the constable, please remember this, underline. What's the name of the landlady? Mrs. Hall, right? Yes. Which place has the scientist come now to live? Ipping, right? And who is the constable? Jaffers is the constable. You have to remember all this now. So keep on underlining any important information that you come across. Mr. Jaffers, the constable, now arrived and was quite surprised to find that he had to arrest a man without a head. How do I arrest this person? Right? But Jaffers was not easily prevented from doing his duties. He's a very dutiful person. So even if I have to arrest a headless person, I'll do that. Okay? So he will arrest him. If a magistrate's warrant ordered a person's arrest, then that person had to be arrested with or without his head. So he's doing his duty. So Mr. Jaffers is the constable and he is performing his duty. Okay. So we'll put a pause over here. And we continue.